I have seen a number of videos and websites promoting something called fertility massage. Can massage increase your fertility? Hi, I'm Dr. Randy Morris. I am a US-based board-certified fertility expert. I sift through hundreds of boring medical studies to extract the important information and present it to you in an easy, straightforward way, so you can get the facts about fertility and fertility treatments and make informed choices. People who promote fertility massage are of two types. The first is regular massage. Let's talk about massage and its effect on stress. There are some studies that suggest that deep massage may have some benefit in helping to reduce stress and even stress hormones like cortisol. However, there are other studies which have not shown a benefit in reducing stress or cortisol. You should interpret any claims like this to be scientifically unproven. Practitioners of fertility massage offer massages of the inner thigh, groin, and abdomen. There are claims that this somehow increases the blood flow to your reproductive organs and that this would improve your fertility. Because your reproductive organs are located deep in your pelvis, which is surrounded on all sides by bones, ligaments, and muscles, none of these types of massages would be able to reach anywhere near any of your reproductive organs or the blood vessels that supply them. So the theory as to why massage might help fertility is fatally flawed right from the start. But is there any scientific data? I first look for any scientific data that fertility massage increases your chances of becoming pregnant naturally. There is none. There is one study that looked at something called undulating massage, which uses a vibrating instrument. They were looking at patients who were attempting pregnancy using frozen embryo transfer. This wasn't a study in which patients were recruited and then randomly assigned to a massage group or a control group. Instead, they looked back at the outcomes of patients who had chosen to do this therapy on their own in the past. They then tried to match them with people who hadn't used the therapy. I couldn't find a copy of the complete study, only an abstract, so I couldn't evaluate whether their study design and analysis was done correctly or not. The authors did claim that the pregnancy rates were higher in those people who got the vibrating massage, however. That's it. There is no other scientific evidence regarding massage and fertility. So should people be charging you for fertility massage? Well, this editorial in the leading massage therapy journal states that even advertising yourself as a fertility massage therapist is unethical. Ethical because it implies there is some difference between fertility massage and other massages, or that there is some pregnancy benefit to performing fertility massage when none has ever been proven. Here is the conclusion from that editorial. Couples suffering from infertility are a vulnerable group and as such must be protected from unethical, misleading, and deceptive advertising and promotion of the benefits of fertility massage. To date, there is no evidence that fertility massage is beneficial, and therefore, any promotion of objective fertility outcomes that would be gained from receiving a fertility massage would be deemed unethical. Remember, this is not from a journal for fertility and IVF doctors. It is a journal by and for massage therapists. Some practitioners of fertility massage make the claim that the benefit comes from performing acupressure. Acupressure involves stimulation of acupuncture points and meridians without the use of acupuncture needles. It is claimed that stimulating a particular acupoint with acupressure can activate small nerve fibers that send impulses into the spinal cord, brain, and even the pituitary gland. There has been one study that looked at whether acupressure can improve the chances for having a baby when using IVF. They specifically studied auricular acupressure, which focuses on the ear. Unlike the massage study I talked about earlier, this study actually did recruit couples to enroll in this study before they went through their IVF treatment. They split them into three groups. One group got no treatment at all. One group received fake acupressure, and the third group got real acupressure. This was a small study, but it was well designed. They found that although there was no difference in the number of eggs retrieved, the fertilization rate, the rate of developing embryos, or the number of embryos transferred, the ear acupressure group did get more pregnancies than the fake group or the control group. Another study looked at IVF patients who had previously failed to become pregnant on previous IVF attempts. Although this study also claimed a benefit to using ear acupressure, there were a number of problems. This study was even smaller than the previous study and did not include critical information such as how they defined recurrent IVF implantation failure and whether the treatment group was similar to the group that was not treated. These two studies make up the total scientific literature about acupressure. The claims that other types of massage therapy have some acupressure benefit beyond the ear have no evidence whatsoever. Like many of the alternative therapies that I talk about on Infertility TV, you may ask, well, what is the harm? Other than wasting your money or getting your hopes up that these techniques may help you, there appears to be little harm to something like ear acupressure. However, pressing on your groin and inner thigh carries a real risk of causing blood clots on those blood vessels and should definitely be avoided. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.